You make real sacrifices. You make real sacrifices. And yeah, bro, like that's the number one thing. Make sacrifices. If I could drop a gem with anything, I'd say make sacrifices, because that's what a lot of folks is scared to make sacrifices. Like they say they want to make it, but nobody wants to make a sacrifice to make it.
Mm.
Get what I'm saying? I got stories for days, bro, so stop me when I'm talking too much. But I'd say like within like the first year of meeting Lugar, we got them. He tells me about Fool's Gold, a show in Atlanta. And I'm like, damn, man. I wanna go to this show, man, but I just I was in school at the time. I was at Norfolk State University, and I was paying my shit out of pocket. Like I'm not paying no Sally Mae. Like I paid all my shit out of pocket. And I just paid that. I just bought a bunch of studio equipment. I just bought a bunch of shit. And I'm like, man, I don't know, man. This trip is gonna be a bitch, but I gotta show this guy that I'm serious. You feel what I'm saying? I'm like, all right, fuck it, I'ma go. And I went down there, and it was a sacrifice at the time, because I'm like, man, I'm really slick fucked up, bro. And I'm hitting people, yo, come with me to Atlanta. Come to Atlanta. Nobody wants to go. I'm like, fuck it. All right. Like, not even want to go. Everybody's like, yeah, bro, we gonna go, bro. We gonna go out there, man. We gonna throw money in the strip club. All right, bro, you ready? Man, you know I can't eat. All right. Bullshit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, and that's what niggas always do. So we end up going, going down there and meeting Lex, like, yo, bro, I told you I was gonna pop out, bro. And that show, bro, is fucking, it's Lex, it's Southside, it's Sunny, it's Metro Boomin, it's TM88, it's Young Thug, it's Travis Scott on, this before I even met Macko, but it's Travis Scott and OG Macko performing together, T.I., man, it's everybody in the game, bro, right there, bro. And I feel like that was like a pivotal moment to just show me like, one, this is a good market to be in, because these are all people that's running the industry right now. And then it also, I think it kind of proved to bro at the time, like, yo, this guy's actually serious about trying to work. You know what I mean? And like I said, like, I'm sitting there like, all right, man, maybe if I put this card in, maybe I could get some money out of this machine, but I don't know. You know what I mean? I made it back with that. And just from me being out there, it ran up the sales at the time for Beats and some other shit going on. And then everything just kind of, you know, spiraled from there. So it's like, it's those real life sacrifices. If you sit at home and you like, man, I ain't gonna take this trip, man. Only got $500, man. I ain't gonna take this trip. But then you take out of the 500, you take 300 and you buy some Yeezys, and then you take the other 200 and you bullshit and buy weed and fucking whatever. It's like, bro, you should have took your last 500 and put that shit towards yourself and invested in yourself. You know what I mean? Go buy a fucking Producergrind loop kit or something.
Wow.
for real, like, you know, that'd be the shit, man. You gotta invest in yourself, man. You gotta make a real sacrifice, bro. If you don't make no sacrifice, you ain't gonna get it. Or if you might get it on some lucky shit, but it ain't gonna last, so you ain't gonna know what to do with it.
All right.
You know?